الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم آمين. The subject of tonight is about Isa, Jesus, peace be unto him, from an Islamic perspective. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the outset of this talk to allow my words to reach the hearts and the minds at the same time. Allahumma ameen. This is going to be a three-segment tablet recording. In the first segment, inshallah, we'll talk about Maryam, Mary, peace be unto her, from an Islamic perspective, and we'll talk about her lineage as well. We'll be quoting some verses, some ayat from the Quran, to report the true account as it was divinely revealed, and we'll interpret in English, add a translated interpretation in English for the sake of those who cannot understand the Arabic language. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله اصطفى آدم ونوحا وآل إبراهيم وآل عمران على العالمين ذرية بعضها من بعض. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses from his slaves, his devotees, those whom he sees fit to deliver the message and to carry certain duties and responsibilities. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, prior to speaking about Mary and Jesus, peace be unto them, he speaks about Adam, our forefather. And he says he has chosen Adam to be the forefather of humanity. And he has chosen Adam to be the messenger for all mankind. In Allah astafa Adam wa Nuha. Nuh is our second forefather, simply because the people of Nuh have all drowned. And everybody who came thereafter came from the lineage of Nuh alayhi salam. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a chronological order, is mentioned in Adam, then Nuh, and then Ibrahim alayhi salam, who is the father of most of the prophets who was sent for mankind. In Allah astafa Adam wa Nuhan wa ala Ibrahim wa ala Imran. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the people of Imran, which are the people of Maryam alayhi salam. And then he says, Durriyatan ba'duha min ba'd, because of their level of righteousness, knowledge, and commitment to Islam, to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions all of them, and he says they are offsprings one from another, meaning that the true lineage between mankind is based on righteousness, piety, knowledge, and devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his religion, and that is the religion of Islam from Adam all the way to Muhammad, including Moses and Jesus, peace be unto them all. ذُرِّيَّةً بَعْضُهَا مِنْ بَعْضُ وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. It was reported that the wife of Imran, and her name was Ashya', and her husband's name was Imran, whose lineage goes back all the way to Dawood, David, alayhi salam. And his name is Imran, his wife's name is Ashya'. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this family, and then he mentions the wife of Imran, Ashya', when she vowed to, you know, once she bears a child, it was reported that she never had any children before, that the first child that she bears, she's going to put him or put her as a servant for the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jerusalem, which is Bayt al-Maqdis in Jerusalem. And this was a tradition of those who were religious, those who were pious, and those who were devotee for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed the wife of Imran, Ashya', with, you know, a baby girl. And the very first day that she was blessed with this baby girl, she named her Maryam. And Maryam in the Arabic language means the devotee for the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا, that the trustee, or the one who was a prophet at the time, his name is Zechariah. He was a prophet and he was the leader in Bani Israel, the Israelites. And they were all under his command. And he was the trustee also over Bayt al-Maqdis, which is known now as, you know, the Dome of the Rock in Jerusalem. So, وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا كُلَّمَا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَّا الْمِحْرَابِ وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا. So every time Zechariah would enter the mihrab, and the mihrab is a special place, a blessed place inside Bayt al-Maqdis, Masjid al-Aqsa. And this place was reserved solely for Mary, peace be unto her. When she reached the age of puberty, she devoted herself and she worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, as he refers to himself in the Quran and in the hadith, which are the statements of the Prophet, peace be unto him. She devoted herself to a such high level of worship in this mihrab that she was the envy of all these devotees and those who are pious and committed to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here, every time Zakariya enters this mihrab, this blessed place in Masjid al-Aqsa, and he witnesses Mary devoting herself day and night to the service and to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا. He would find that she has sustenance. She would have sustenance. And the narrators say that she would have the sustenance means that the fruits of the summer in the winter, and the fruits of the winter in the summer, which is clear indication that this is an honorable act, an act of honor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon this righteous woman, and this one that is yet to be the mother or one of the greatest prophets to walk the face of the earth, and that is Jesus, peace be unto him. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا قال يا مريم أن لك هذا. He would ask, oh Mary, where did this come from? Of course, he's not questioning the integrity of Mary, because this has nothing to do with integrity. When you find something miraculous taking place in front of you, you're not questioning the integrity of this person, but rather you're inquiring as to how this has happened. So he's looking for an explanation from Mary. The simple answer that she gave to him, which is an answer that he, as a prophet, and a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can fully understand, قالت هو من عند الله. She said, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he bestows his sustenance, his rizq, upon a devotee or upon a slave of his, he puts no account. He does not calculate. He simply bestows his rizq without account. إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Now, what we know from the Quran and the Sunnah, that Zakariya has reached such a high stage or such an advanced stage in life, reached a very old age, as mentioned in this chapter that we mentioned, the chapter of Al Imran, and as mentioned also in the chapter that is titled Mary. Chapter of Al Imran is number 3 in the Quran, and the chapter that is titled Maryam or Mary is chapter number 19 in the Quran. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كاف ها يا عين صاد ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال ربي إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is recorded in this surah, chapter titled Mary, the dialogue between him and Zechariah, when he said, oh Allah, I have reached such an advanced stage in my life, and I'm in no position to have children. فَهَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ وَلِيَّ. Oh Allah, grant me from your bounties a wali, meaning that a child, a righteous child that's going to carry the message of Islam. And I say the message of Islam because, as I mentioned at the outset of this talk, that all the religions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent all of his prophets with are the religions of Islam. And Islam means the religion of submission. The religion of submission to the one and only one, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the owner and the controller of the dominion of the heavens and the earth and all that's in between. So when Zechariah saw this miracle taking place in front of him, with the sustenance being bestowed upon Mary, he said, he made a dua in the Arabic language, of course, which is roughly translated to mean, O you who are the one who bestows his sustenance out of season upon his devotees, bestow upon me a righteous child, even though I have reached such an old age and my wife is barren, she cannot bear any children anymore because of her late age. فنادته الملائكة وهو قائم يصلي بالمحراب أن الله يبشرك بيحيى. So the angels called unto him as he stood up in the late night hours, praying and supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the good news of having a righteous child. And his name is Yahya. And Yahya is also a prophet and a messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So even before the birth of Isa alayhi salam, we had at that time two prophets, and that is Zechariah, and then Yahya, who is the son of Zechariah. And then when Zechariah asked, oh Allah, how am I going to have a child and have reached such an old age? قَالَ كَذَلِكَ اللَّهُ يَفْعَلُ مَا يَشَاءُ. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty says, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need the relationship that we have with the physical world, the cause-effect relationship. He simply says when he wants something to be and it is. Be and it is. So there is no cause-effect relationship. The rules of the universe apply to us in the physical world. they do not apply to the Creator as the one who created the physical world and the rules that govern this physical world. Now, the mother of Mary, peace be upon her, she vowed to devote Mary to the service of Bayt al-Maqdis. Then Mary now is born, and she is reached of the age of puberty. She's a devotee, she's a good service woman at the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Bayt al-Maqdis. And now the angels are calling unto Mary. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us a slew of different miracles that have taken place to set the stage for us for another miracle that is yet to take place, or rather a slew of miracles that is about to take place. And the first of which is when the angels call unto Mary. إِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَهَّرَكِ وَاصْطَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ. When the angels call unto Mary, they said, "Oh Mary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, has chosen you. And because of your righteousness, and your piety, and your devotion, وَطَهَّرَكِ, and He has purified you." So He has chosen you and purified you. وَاصْطَفَاكِ, and another act of selection for this specific task. وَاصْطَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ, upon all the women, or over all the women of the world. Some of the scholars said the women at her time. Some said no, women at large, that she is the number one woman and the most righteous that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed on the face of the earth. Ya Maryam, inna Allah astafaki wa tahharaki wa astafaki ala nisa' al-alameen. And as a result of this election and selection, if you will, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded her, Ya Maryam, iqnuti li rabbiki wasjudi warka'i ma'a al-raki'in. O Mary, iqnuti li rabbiki, means be in a state of obedience at all times. Wasjudi, and be in a state of prostration and bowing. And make sujood with those who are prostrating themselves, be it in the heavens or on earth, with for the service and for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, it is not a coincidence that Zechariah was the trustee of Mary. Zechariah, as we said, was a prophet, so he was the most qualified, and he was also the husband of Mary's maternal aunt. And in some narrations, Mary's sister, but the preponderance of the evidence showed that he was the husband of Mary's paternal aunt. So therefore, he was most qualified in terms of knowledge, in terms of devotion, and in terms of lineage, that he was closer to her than anyone else, devoted themselves in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Bayt al-Maqdis in Jerusalem. وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكِ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْهُ اسْمُهُ الْمَسِيحُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Now the angels are calling unto Mary for the second purpose of selecting her as a devotee and as a woman of mission, as a righteous woman of mission. They said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the news, commanded us to deliver the news to you, that you shall bear a child without a husband, without being married. She said, out of curiosity, how am I going to bear a child? Not questioning the will or the ability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the natural instinct of a human being, if a woman is told that you're going to bear a child, that means there's an interaction between a man and a woman. قَالَتْ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ. She said, Oh Allah, in chapter 12 of Mary, Oh Allah, how am I going to have a child and no human being has ever touched me? It means that I've never been married, I never had any intimate relationships with a man. قَالَ كَذَلِكِ اللَّهُ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates as He wills. إِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. When He decrees a thing, He simply says, be and it is. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given Mary the news of what this child is going to be like. And He says, وَيُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا وَرَسُولًا وَنَبِيًّا مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And He will speak to people in the cradle. Meaning that the moment he's born, he's going to have the ability to speak. And he's going to, وَيُعَلِّمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَالتَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will teach him the book, and the wisdom, and the Old Testament, and the New Testament. وَيُبْرِئُ الْأَكْمَهَ وَالْأَبْرَصَ وَيُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. And he will heal الْأَكْمَهَ وَالْأَبْرَصَ, those who are blind, and those who have skin disease, and those leprosy, and those who are dead, that he will bring them to life. Now, will bring them to life not by way of his own doing, but rather bi-idhnillah. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a very meticulous and very detailed articulation in the Quran, stresses this fact, that nothing in the dominion and of the heavens and the earth takes place without the will and the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says, وَيُبْرِئُ الْأَكْمَهَ وَالْأَبْرَصَ وَيُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. So all of that by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in addition to other miracles. So the next next event that takes place is that Mary, peace be unto her, now she bears a child, and this child is going to be, as we mentioned, one of the five mighty prophets to ever walk the face of the earth. And this narration is mentioned in details in chapter number 19, which is titled Mary in the Quran, the one and the only one divine book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in existence since the coming of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be unto him, the seal of all messengers. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمَ إِذِ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا. And mention in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is an honorable thing to say, and to be mentioned in the divine book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he honors Mary in so many ways, including mentioning her and her story and her son, Jesus, peace be unto him, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمَ إِذِ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا. And mention in the book Mary when she drew to a place in the east. فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا. And then she has taken a barrier away from her people. فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا. Then we have sent her our ruh. And the ruh here refers to the archangel Gabriel. And Gabriel is the trustee of the heavens, is the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about in the Quran, as he says, مُطَاعٌ ثَمَّ أَمِينٌ, that he is obeyed in the heavens and on earth. And he is the one who communicated all divine revelations and messages between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the prophets and the messengers on earth. And he is the one who delegates all tasks to the rest of the angels and the seven layers of the heavens. فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sends an angel to a human being, he's not going to send this angel in the form of an angel. Just a brief description of how our Prophet, peace be unto him, Muhammad, has described Jibreel alayhi salam, when he says, when he saw him twice in his real image, he said he blocked the view of the heavens. So you can imagine the immense of creation of Gabriel, peace be unto him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to send Gabriel in that form to a human being that's barely 5-6 foot tall, standing on earth. How are they going to communicate? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his infinite knowledge and wisdom, sends this archangel Gabriel to Mary, peace be unto her. Peace be unto her. فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. In the form of a human being that is a rather good looking human being. So this way it's a form of safety and security for Mary not to be terrified or scared by an image that she's not familiar with. قَالَتْ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ مِنْكَ إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيًّا. She said, I seek refuge in the All Gracious. And the All Gracious is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, it's the second most personal pronoun, noun of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he calls himself the All Gracious, Ar-Rahman. قَالَتْ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ. She said, I seek refuge in the All Gracious from you, if you're truly a pious and righteous person. Meaning that the only impact or influence that these words would have upon this individual, if that individual is truly pious and righteous. قَالَتْ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ مِنْكَ إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيًّا. He got to the point right away. He said, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَسُولُ رَبِّكِ لِأَهَبَ لَكِ غُلَامًا زَكِيًّا. He said, I am the messenger of your Lord, and I'm delivering the message to you as I was commanded, to give you the news of bearing a child, and that is Isa, Jesus, peace be unto him. قَالَتْ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي وَلَدٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ وَلَمْ أَكُ بَغِيًّا. She said, how am I going to bear a child, and no human being has ever touched me, I'm not married, and I'm not a woman who's known to be impious, to be unrighteous, and practice adultery, similar to what we see prevalent these days, that the only relationship that Islam recognizes is a relation between a husband and wife, between a husband and wife inside an intimate relationship, inside this sacred bond, and nothing outside of this bond in any other form or shirk is recognized to be legit and valid under the Islamic jurisprudence from Adam alayhi salam all the way to Muhammad, peace be unto them. قالت إني أعوذ بالرحمن منك إن كنت تقيا. قال إنما أنا رسول ربك لأهب لك غلاما زكيا. غلاما زكيا means a pure and righteous child. That's who Jesus, peace be on to him. Just a few words as an introduction to Mary as to who is she going to bear. فَحَمَلَتْهُ فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًّا. Of course, Mary, when she questioned as to how am I going to bear this child without a husband, Jibreel alayhi salam, Gabriel said, this is the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it's a decreed thing and shall come to happen no matter what. Then she resigned to the fact that this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and she's accepting as a devotee, as a pious and righteous woman, whatever the Almighty, her Creator and our Creator, decrees to her. فَحَمَلَتْهُ فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًّا. Now she's bearing the child for 9 months, and she withdrew to a very far place, fearing for her safety, fearing from what people will say, fearing from the scandal of being witnessed to be pregnant without having known to be, you know, a married woman. فَحَمَلَتْهُ فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًّا فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَى جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًّا. Now, as she felt that the time has come for her to deliver this baby, she withdrew to the trunk of a palm tree. It is not known in the Quran whether this was in the summer, the fall, the winter, or the spring. We don't know. But irrespective of the season, the point is, when this woman, peace be unto her, withdrew to the trunk of a palm tree, no family, she's hungry, she's thirsty, no form of security whatsoever, she's all alone, she's afraid of the scandal. So here she is expressing the feelings of a human being, in spite of the fact that she knows that she is divinely supported and that she is divinely decreed to bear this child, and she has done absolutely nothing wrong. قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا. She said, I wish I have died before this has happened to me, and I was a forgotten thing. فَنَادَاهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا. Then one called unto her from underneath her. We don't know if this caller was Jesus, peace be unto him, or the angel, that she was in his care during the delivery. فَنَادَاهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي قَدْ جَعَلَ رَبُّكِ تَحْتَكِ سَرِيًّا. So he called unto her from underneath, do not be saddened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has caused a stream of water to flow from underneath you. فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا. So shake the palm tree, eat from the dates of the palm tree, drink from the water, and وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا, and have the comfort of looking at this beautiful child as he was born with this bright light in his face, and that is Jesus, peace be unto him. فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا فَإِمَّا تَرَيِنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا فَقُولِ إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَلَّى. So now, as you deliver and you're feeling better, and you're going to go back to your people carrying this baby, if you see anyone, say that I vowed, by way of signaling, say that I vowed to Ar-Rahman, again, the All Gracious, not to speak to any human being. فَقُولِ إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا. I vowed not to speak to anyone. فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيَّ. I shall not speak to any human being today. So here, the wisdom behind that is that, be it, you know, in the 21st or the 25th century or the 18th or any other century whatsoever, if a woman who's never been married and is known to be a righteous woman comes to her people carrying a child, and now she's going to say that I bore and deliver this child without the interference of any man whatsoever, the odds are nobody's going to believe her. So therefore, it was of no use for her to speak and to say anything. She looked among the Israelites again. It was of no use for her to speak or to say anything. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded her not to say anything, not to speak to any human being. And from this point on, it is Jesus, peace be unto him, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enabled him to speak in the cradle. He's the one who will be taking the conversation from this point on. We'll mention something briefly about what Jesus, peace be unto him, has said, and then we'll continue, inshallah, in the next session, talking about Jesus, peace be unto him, who he was. He was he a prophet? Was he a son of God? Was he a God himself? Was he one of the three? What is the true account with respect to Jesus, peace be unto him, from a divine, the one and the only true and divine perspective, and that is the Quran. So here, Mary comes to her people, she returns to her people, she's carrying this baby. The first thing, of course, even after knowing her to be a pious, righteous, and a devotee, they questioned her integrity immediately. They said, قَالُوا يَا مَرْيَمْ لَقَدْ جِئْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيًّا. They immediately started with the accusation. They said, oh Mary, you have certainly done something hideous, something of tremendous proportions. Ya Maryam, ma kana abuki imra'a sawin, wa ma kanat ummuki baghiya. Oh Mary, we know your father Imran. He was not a man, he was not an evil man. He was not an unpious man. وَمَا كَانَتْ أُمُّكِ بَغِيَّةً. And your mother was not a prostitute, because she was also known for his right, for her righteousness. So therefore here they openly admit that she comes from an honorable lineage. Her father, her mother, her forefathers, be it on the paternal or maternal side. But yet they did not spare anything except to accuse her in her honor and her integrity. فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. At this point she points to Isa عليه السلام. And the first words that came out of Jesus, peace be unto him, after his birth, when he was in the cradle, قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. He said, I am the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. InshaAllah, we'll resume this talk about Isa alayhi salam and the continuation of his conversation as to what he has said, and what the Israelites have said about him, what the Christians have said about him, and what the true account in the Quran speaks about Jesus, peace be unto him, in the next session. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر استغفروا سبحانك رب حمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.